Hi everyone, Lisa Haven here, and have I got a huge extra special surprise for you today. With everything that's going on with Donald Trump being elected to presidency and our president today, with the economy reaching $20 trillion in debt and the instabilities that have been going up and down in the market for decades, and all the chaos that surrounds near on the brink economic system, I thought I've got to bring Charles, is it Thorngren, right? I have that right?
It is.
Charles Thorngren on, and he's with Noble Gold Investments, and he does gold, silver, and other precious metals, but he's got some amazing things to tell you guys specifically in regards to the IMF, the economy, and everything in that nature. Well, Charles, are you with me over there?
I am glad to be here.
Well, I'm so glad to bring you on. I've been wanting to bring someone who does gold and silver on for a while because I think it is absolutely critical, especially now that Donald Trump is in office. Can you tell us, I guess, where you see the economy right now? Let's just start with that. Are we really and truly on an unstable path with that?
Great question. And I think, you know, it's pretty obvious. I think the people out there know what's going on in the economy. We see this massive amount of debt, and we've been told it's okay, everything's going fine, but we know what's going on in our own neighborhoods. We see the people who don't have full-time jobs yet. They had to get piecemeal jobs here and there to get by. So the idea that everything is fine, it's just another concept we're being fed to make us believe that we should just trust and not question anything. But the reality is $20 trillion in debt is a ridiculous number. It's a number that when you compare it, if you took all the currencies of the world, all the precious metals in the world, all of the cryptocurrencies, it would only cover 65% of that debt. So that's a number that is just really needs to be magnified in people's minds to say, how do we fix this? How do we protect ourselves? And ultimately, that's where we look towards, you know, gold and silver. It's that safety that's been there for 5,000 years. That's what's going to protect you in the worst case scenarios. And really, the process of it is so easy that it makes sense to look into it.
Absolutely. And that's why I thought, hey, you know, I'm a big supporter of, you know, things like prepping, having gold and silver on hand, because these are the things that have protected people over the years. But I mean, when we don't have enough of our U.S. debt or debt in whole backed by these precious metals, we're looking at some major problems here. And what that specifically tells me is that, you know, our precious metals, our gold and silver, are only going to increase in value, and people make money off of these things, do they not, when they have this gold, because it continues to go up?
Absolutely. It most people understand the stock market. So when we look at this, we can kind of equate it to that, but understand that it's a tangible asset. So it's not just a number on a screen for you, but as the dollar gets weaker, the precious metals go up in value because it takes more of those dollars to buy that gold and that silver. That's how it works. Its value has been pretty constant. It's everything else that deteriorates. And that's what we have a situation with. As the dollar gets weaker, it takes more of those dollars to get that gold and that silver. So when you look at it from that scenario, effectively, yes, in our minds, we make money. But actually what we've done is we saved ourselves from the loss, which is far more important, because given the opportunity, people want to maintain what they have. Making money on it, that's great. We don't want to lose. And that's what precious metals do for you. They give you the ability to not lose and go up against those paper dollars that we use in currency and trading.
You know, that's why I like your, you know, Noble Gold Investments, because there's a lot of crooked gold, you know, agencies out there. And I know you guys are the real deal. And even better, you guys aren't, you know, out the roof and doing crooked things like some of these people, which is why I'm like, oh yeah, Charles is definitely coming on. So because I trust you and I trust your organization and I just love what you do. But in addition, I think we really need to get to the root of this because a lot of people, and I've heard this, you know, from different people, oh, well, we don't need a prep anymore. Donald Trump's in office. We don't need to worry about the economy. Donald Trump's in office. And I like Donald Trump, but I have to say he's not the savior. And we are literally going on an unstable path with him. I mean, he's doing amazing things for our country, but we're talking about an economic nightmare. Can you maybe expand on that a little?
Sure, sure. And I'm right there with you with Donald Trump. The important thing about President Trump is that he's going to start to make the changes. It has to start someplace. So thank God he's there and we can begin to fix the problem. Without that, we're in trouble. Just because we start something doesn't mean it's going to be easy. Great things take energy, they take effort. And this is not something that we have to remember. This is not something that the system that's in place right now wants to see happen. Anytime you have a true change, a change of people's mindsets, a change of policies, the old policy doesn't just go away and say, oh, we lost, we're done. No, this is a political system that wants to maintain its power. This is an economic system that wants to maintain its power. And we see that when comments from Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan, they're coming out now saying, oh, it's over. Donald Trump has played out. The president, he had his moment. No, it's just the start. But we have to expect that. We have to say, okay, they're not going to just turn and walk away. They've made far too much money doing it, and they've gotten far too much power. So there is resistance. Expect that. But the important thing is getting started. And we see a scenario. In April, we have the next IMF meeting. It's a very important time. That's when the organization of the International Monetary Fund decides whose currency controls the world. Now, our dollar's been under attack for a very long time, within our system and without. So we see a moment here where you have China, backed by Russia, that are proposing to replace the dollar as the ultimate reserve currency and create a basket of currencies.
What would that do to the dollar?
Well, here's what that would do. People would no longer have to hold it. Right now, they have to hold it. They want to do international trade. They want to be able to trade on a world banking system. They need the US dollar. So now if you have countries, and we have some countries out there that don't like us, we know this. If they don't need to hold our currency, you know what they're going to do? They're going to get rid of it. And that creates a downward pressure on an already broken system. That's what could really lead to a very stunning turn of events for our wealth as Americans. You know, without that currency, without that backing of the dollar, the stock market doesn't have the legs that it does right now. And we're already at an all-time high. So we have some situations that coming together perfectly to cause a lot of concern for us as a nation with our currency, but also for us as investors and savers. We have to take those steps to protect ourselves.
Now, if we have gold in our possession, or you know, precious metals or silver in our possession, that retains its value. So even if the dollar were to hit the crapper, so to speak, and just falter, then we still got solid ground with gold and silver.
Correct. It actually works the opposite of the dollar. So the more the dollar loses value, the higher your value of gold. And unique scenario, because right now, gold as it is already undervalued. We had all that fake money being pumped into the stock market through the banks, which owned your investment firms. Very interesting, the thing that happened there, that suddenly Bank of America owns Merrill Lynch. Chase Bank owns JP Morgan. Should have never happened, but it did. So when all that quantitative easing was released to the banks and there was no interest rate, so they couldn't make any money by lending us people, business owners and companies money, they put it in the stock market. So you have a scenario where gold has been held down. It's got an artificial value right now. Silver as well. And what happens anytime you, I like the analogy of holding a ball underwater. As soon as you release your hands, not only does it go back to the service, it jumps way up into the air. And that's what's going to happen with your metals, because there's been such a downward pressure on them. When they begin the move, they're going to move very fast, and they're going to elevate in price quite quickly.
I agree. And that's why I think it's a good opportunity to jump on it now before that ball goes shooting up in the air and you've got more investments. It's only a matter of time. And so we're kind of waiting on that ticking time bomb. This is why, you know, you can put your 401ks, IRAs, you can change those to gold, correct?
Right.
Or silver.
Right.
Yeah. And so these are very important things to do. But here's the thing. When we are fighting globalist monsters, because that's what they are, we have the IMF, JP Morgan Chase, Goldman Sachs, all these bankers and globalists. And then we have Donald Trump getting in, who is anti-globalist and wants to build up our America. These JP Morgan Chase, Goldman Sachs, the IMF, they're not going to give up without a fight.
No.
And I think we're about to see the epic battle commence, so to speak. And that's why it could get pretty crazy. And that's why I'm telling everyone, you can't just stop right now. We're on the brink of some pretty crazy things, and we don't know which way the cookie's going to crumble, so to speak. And with the IMF, I know that you're saying they want to dump the dollar, and there's a lot of foreigners cashing out the dollar. I've been looking up that, and that's when we get into that level. And then we have the United Nations, where U.S. is the biggest donor. Yeah. Next to us is China. And they're really bucking up to China right now, their second biggest donor, and trying to get China to cash out some of our stuff. As I guess, I don't know if you want to call it revenge or payback, because they're worried Donald Trump could leave the UN. And I don't know if that'll ever happen. But needless to say, all these play into where we're at economically speaking. And the IMF, let's go back to the IMF. What is their ultimate goal? I mean, do they want a one world currency? What currency are they wanting to promote?
Well, that's the thing that's interesting, is they do want a one world currency. Obviously, it's easier to control. So the way you accomplish that is you create a baskets of currencies. You get everyone in the mix, right? And then you just say, well, you know what? This is so complicated. Why don't we just create one trading unit, since we're all equally involved and we're all equally represented? And then, the thing about that kind of change is they have to make it seem like it makes sense. If they don't, then people will rise up. But they want to ease us into it. So by creating this this basket of currencies that represents everybody, it's just so easy to say, why don't we just create this one unit that represents everything? And that's where you see them going. You know, one of the things, just because you and I are aware of what's going on, or the listeners are aware of what's going on, doesn't mean that everyone is. So in a situation like the IMF, they have to convince those who don't know and make it sound like this makes perfect sense, or else people won't fall for it.
Yep, absolutely. And that's the other thing is, here's one more, I guess I'm going to throw one final straw in there, but the elitists, the globalists, the uber rich, so to speak, they're buying up, prepping houses. They're, buying up places underground even. But not only that, they're also buying gold, silver, absolutely, precious metals. And if you want to really know what the future holds, and, you could look to some of the things that they're doing and say, I got to do that too, because a lot of these globalists, have plans for countries, and they're going to do everything they can to get that done. And if they're buying gold and silver, well, we need to do it too as a safeguard. Just my two cents. What's your take on that?
Absolutely. They say if you want to become wealthy, follow the wealthy people. They know what they're doing. But here's the thing. People haven't looked into it because it seemed difficult. It's not. Give us a call. We'll walk you through the process. We make it as easy as we can for you, and we treat you the way you should be treated. So understand that it's difficult to understand because you're looking at it for the first time, possibly. But once you get a hold of us and we explain the process to you, we help you do all the paperwork. If you're doing your IRAs or your 401k rollovers, we take the heavy work out of it. But more importantly is we make it understandable. We're going to break it down to you in English, not in some crazy financial jargon, so that you understand what's going on, so that you feel better about your decision. So the most important thing, know that it is easy. Even if you don't understand how it is, you call us and we'll explain it. And you're going to get the safety you want. Everyone's concerned. Everyone has concerns about what's going on with their finances. It's human nature. So get the safety you need and do it in a manner that makes it very easy and convenient for you. Give us a call.
Agreed. And, you know, we can't continue to allow this mega secret by the IMF to hold us down and hold us back of this global currency and what they're attempting to do. So, Charles, can you share your number, your website information, all of that? I've kind of flopped it on the screen now and then also. But I just want to say before you do that, I back this company. I believe in this company. If you don't go with someone, if you don't go with Charles's organization, Noble Gold Investments, like blah. But if you don't go with them, go with someone. But get on that bandwagon. Start checking into gold and silver. But I really believe in Charles' company, and he has some of the best competing prices out there, and they really are solid and real deal. All right, go ahead. Share all that info. Number as well.
Perfect. NobleGoldInvestments.com. That's our website. You can reach us at 888-596-7916. And just know, when you give us a call, we're going to give you the advice you need. We're going to give you the information you need to make the best decision. And we're going to give it in the most costly manner for you. It's going to be the most cost-effective way to protect yourself. If you're looking around, please do. But give us a call as well. And then you'll find out why you see the reviews on our company the way that you have. You'll find out why we have no complaints on our company. Because we really do focus on our customers. It's just who we are. That's what we do. So again, visit us at NobleGoldInvestments.com. There's a lot of fantastic information there. If you don't want to give us a call, go there, request some of the information that we have. We'll get it right out to you. If you want to speak to somebody, give us a call here at 888-596-7916.
Awesome. Thank you, Charles. And also just let them know you heard it here on Lisa Haven's channel with Charles and I. And I think that's it. Well, thanks again for tuning in. Please don't forget to check out all those links below. I'm going to leave every link in the description box below in the YouTube channel, so you can check those out as well. Anyhow, thanks again for tuning in. This is Lisa Haven and Charles signing out.